Excel's been the go-to spreadsheet for years, but what if there is a smarter way to handle data? Quadratic uses AI to analyze, summarize, and visualize data without all the manual work. Hey everyone, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. I love finding the best tech tools to help you work smarter, not harder. And today, I'm diving into Quadratic, a next-generation spreadsheet that combines AI, Python, and databases into one powerful tool. If you're tired of Excel formulas and want something new and more intuitive, stick around. I'll put the link to Quadratic down below in the description. I'm just using the personal one that is completely free, and so you can start checking this out right away. But I'm going to go get logged into my Quadratic account now. I'm going to start with just creating a brand new file in Quadratic. I'm going to go up top to do it here. Notice that we can import files as well. So if I want to import CSV, Excel, you can see all the different file extensions. I can connect data with an API, and I am going to show you these two with some examples. These examples here, they have lots of different files already set up with data and visualizations in them that you can check out, and it really helps you understand how Quadratic works. But I'm going to go to New File, because what I want to just show you really quickly is the similarities to something like Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets, just to make you feel comfortable using it. You can go to any cell, and I can type in a number, and then I can go to a different cell, type in something else. So all that works the same. I can go and put a formula in any of these cells, just like using any of the other spreadsheets. I can go type it in, hit enter, and it will do so. It has access to all the different functions by doing it the same way. So if I was just going to pick this, select my cells, and you can see how everything works the same. Now, something different though, if I go to a cell here and I just hit /, this is where I can code directly into a cell. So let me give you an example in Python. I'm not going to go through all of these, but if I go to Python, I could go and type a formula in up here. So if I was just going to say let's go 5 × 23, and I run this like this, you can see now it shows me that this is Python. This is the code over here. Now, the other thing it can do, so I just went to a different cell and hit the /. Again, if I was going to go and just think about normal Python, if I click print and let's say I wanted we'll just do the hello. You can see how it's filling everything out, and I'll just say hello. There's a console down here, so I can see what the output is. So if I hit play, notice it is going to be put out here. If I just get rid of one of the, let's say I get rid of the brackets and I'm going to run this again, and I should get an error. I can fix an AI chat. So this is a handy thing. Any of the different coding that you can do and use this fix in AI chat, because then you can see the fix. I can apply and run it, and it fixed it, and I can accept it. These are all just great features to have on it. Now let's move on to something else to show you that I can create on these sheets using the AI. I just went and cleared the data on the sheet that we just put in here. Notice over here, I want to show you the power of the AI can do many different things for you. So they have some quick little prompts here you can test it out with. Here's one with create a table, all 50 states with their population and GDP. You can just go ahead and click on any of these, or you could ask it something yourself. So if I go ahead and put this in, display the data of the top 10 quarterbacks of the NFL by QBR, maybe I'll put a year in it too. We'll say 2023, because I have asked this before, so I knew 2024, the data set wasn't there that they could pull it from. But as it goes through, you'll see it add this to the spreadsheet. Now, here's the data that they returned here. You notice that they even gave more information than what the QBR they have, but they also put all this other information. So they were able to go out, get the information, and put it back into this sheet. So, but now maybe I want to see them put it to some type of chart, and let's go and ask them this. So I'm going to go down below here and change this and just say chart the info. And I'm not telling what type of chart to pick, but usually they pick ones that will fit most appropriately on it. But you can always ask it to change to a different type of chart. All right, now we have our chart that they created here. All of those top 10 are put into this. I could go ahead and say make it the top 5 or 4, and you can see how quickly, there it is, as it goes through, and now it will adjust it to that. The power of the AI right inside this spreadsheet to go and get the data and then visualize it. This is a game changer how quickly you can work with it. I could go ahead and keep chatting with the AI to keep making changes. Or if I go to the drop down here, open code editor, if you wanted to code it in any of the changes, you can go ahead and do that and then just hit run again and those changes will be reflected. I'm going to go ahead and give this a name. I'm just going to call this QBR. Now I'm going to go back. If I hit over here, back to the dashboard, it brings me to this, and this is where your files will be stored. I can go ahead and delete them or move them depending on how you want everything organized. Now, what I want to point out over here is the docs, because if as you're diving into this, I'm just touching on a few things here. This is a great way to learn about Quadratic. If you're looking for something specific, you can do a search up here, but they have all the different information to help you with different things in it. So just remember where that file is. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and create a new file again this time because I want to show you how quickly you could bring a CSV file into this. I could go and upload, but I have one on my computer right here on my desktop. I'm going to drag it in and drop it like that. That was all in live time, how quickly it moves right over into this. Now, if I drop down, you can see I can make some adjustments. Maybe I want to use the first row as the column names and I can quickly change it to reflect what I had in my original file. With the CSV I just brought in, let me show you how quickly you can visualize the data. So now I want to know, I'm going to ask the AI this, what are the total units sold by state? So this would be a normal pivot table question in Excel. They would take this large amount of data and I could go through and do it that way. But if I go ahead and just send this off in a matter of seconds and I have the information right over here. So and it gives me a walkthrough of what it did. You can see I've created a summary table showing the units sold. Maybe now what I want though is to have it graph. So again, I'm just going to ask it, I'll say please chart. Did you see how easy that was to do? I just asked the AI a couple of questions, and even if I didn't know how to do any of this Python coding that you could go and open the editor and see, it didn't matter because I could just use the AI to visualize the data that I wanted from that original file. I want to show you how you can make an API request in Quadratic using Python. And I want to show you a few different ways, because if you know how to code, you could go to a cell and like I've showed you before, you could forward slash go to Python and just do your code. Now, I'm not a coder. I know very little to be effective with Python. But if I go over and I can read instructions back to that file that I showed you before and I'm under make an API request, I could copy this right here into the code and just go ahead and put my API URL in here and that will work. But the other way I could do this is just by getting AI to help me. So if I just ask AI, create an example API request, it will go through and create the code for me. And then I can go and take the API that URL and just change it. So here's the example. I have Python open up over here. And I'm just going to go ahead now and change the URL here to what I want. So I have this web page open. This is just a weather forecaster. And I believe I have Seattle selected as the place. And if I go down, all I want to have is the maximum temperature and minimum temperature here. I can see the settings, what they're going to be in here. And this looks fine. I'm going to reload the chart and see what we get. So it's something like this. But I'm going to take this right here, this API URL. I'm going to just go Control C. I'm going to go back over and I'm just going to replace this in. Now, the great thing is, if it doesn't work right away, you have that fix option that I showed you before too. So I'm just going to run this. And just like that, I have the information. So if I go down below, I can even chat inside the code chat here. I could say, create a chart from this. I hopefully create a line chart. Notice I haven't been asking for them specifically on this. So I'm going to go ahead and create a chart and we'll see what it does bring back. All right, so I can see 43 lines of code here. I'm just going to go ahead, apply and run. I'm going to go ahead and accept here. And we can see that we have our chart created. So just by importing that in from that API URL, I was able to bring that in and all I had to do was change this URL address. So using the AI is a great option, even if you don't have the coding skills to get up and started with Quadratic. The last thing I want to show you today is how easy it is to share in Quadratic. Just simply go up top, put the emails of people that you want to collaborate with, give them the access level, is it edit or view? Notice that we can even have team in Quadratic. So if I go back to the dashboard here and just drop down under my team, we can create a team. This isn't going to be under the free version like I'm working in today. So I hope you like this walkthrough of Quadratic and understand how much faster this can make your data analysis using AI. I'm really impressed with how everything works and how quickly you can dig into the numbers. Let me know what you think down below in the comments if this could be something that would work with you. Go and check them out with the link also. Have a great day.